So, picture this, right? The world has already ended around sometime in 2012. You must be immediately thinking to yourself, how are we here then? Hold on to that thought for a moment while I ask you a couple of questions. Is the world the same place it was 10 years ago? What about just a year ago? Is the world even the same place it was just a year ago? Or a month ago? A week ago? Even yesterday? Even yesterday, is the world even the same place it was yesterday? As time goes on, the world slowly becomes a more different place. So naturally, it may be logical to assume that old versions of the world are always dying to bring in new ones as time goes on. It is common to see a photo as a snapshot in time. However, that photo still took time to create. Time must have been allowed for the shutters of the camera to open and close. Time must have been allowed for the camera to fully formulate the photo into its memory. And time must have been allowed for the light waves to travel off the objects and into the camera lens. So even though we can get really, really close, we still have no way of capturing an instance in time. An instance in time would have to be the smallest divisible factor in time, and it would likely be defined as a period of time from the present minus a period of time from the past divided by infinity. With this definition of an instant, there would be an infinite amount of instances in any given time frame. From this lens, it becomes clear how time might just be an illusion. So, what does this all mean in relation to the world ending in 2012? Well, if we are unable to perceive of time in its smallest increments, then theoretically, if the world ended and we were all instantaneously shifted into an alternate universe similar to the one we ended, we would have no idea. For the sake of this YouTube video, that is exactly what happened. On July 4th, 2012, an organization known as CERN launched up the Large Hadron Collider for yet another time after years of prior use. However, this time, CERN was about to discover something groundbreaking. It is known as the Higgs Bosson Particle, or God Particle, and its discovery has helped scientists answer many questions they couldn't answer about particle physics for decades. One of the leading discoveries about this particle is that it may be the reason that mass is able to exist at all. Could a discovery this groundbreaking be grounds for world catastrophe? Stephen Hawking believes so. According to Hawking, the God particle becomes very unstable under certain conditions, including near speed of light collisions. Hawking believes that it is possible that a wrong collision may cause the God particle to break and cause a ripple effect across the entire rest of the universe. Since the God particle is responsible for the existence of mass, an event like this would cause all matter to lose its mass, which would simultaneously cause space-time to collapse in on itself. So long story short, the Hadron Collider could theoretically bring an abrupt end to everything as we know it. However, it should be noted that Hawking claimed that it would take a larger collider for this theory to be feasible. With everything that has been said, I could go ahead and end the video right here if it weren't for a particular strange phenomenon that many people have heard of before. This phenomenon is known as the Mandela effect, and as we look into it more closely, you may wonder if the world actually has ended. If you're not familiar with the Mandela effect, here is a quick breakdown. The Mandela effect actually has very little to do with Nelson Mandela, and other things seemingly uncorrelated like the Monopoly Man and Star Wars will show up when you search this term. This is because the Mandela effect gets its name from one of the first occurrences this phenomenon has been observed. When Nelson Mandela died in 2013, there were a lot of people who were suddenly very confused. They could have sworn they remembered Nelson Mandela dying in prison many years ago. It was not just a couple of people that remembered this about Mandela. It was thousands, if not millions, of people. These people often weren't just going off hunches either. Many people felt absolutely certain that Mandela died because they had vivid memories of his death and of mourning for it. Like I said, this does not only include Nelson Mandela. There are a lot of random things that are affected by the Mandela effect. One of the most famous ones would have to be the scene in Star Wars where Luke Skywalker finds out that Darth Vader is his father. Now, many people remember quoting this movie as, "Luke, I am your father," but if you watch the footage, it actually says something a little bit differently.
"No, I am your father."
The Monopoly Man, yeah, he actually doesn't have monocles and never did. And when this phenomenon was first discovered, I couldn't believe it because JCPenney, Fruit Loops, and Captain Crunch were all spelled differently than I had remembered overnight. So the Mandela effect is strange, and it would make sense that we would have different memories if we somehow shifted into some kind of alternate universe. The one thing that does not seem to fully add up about this theory is how we entered a new universe immediately after ending our old one. One of the few explanations for this would be that consciousness itself is its own separate force and exists independently from material reality. Consciousness would have to be indestructible and persistent. There is some evidence that supports this. For example, when we go to sleep every night, we become conscious in our dreams. Many people believe in an afterlife, and for those who don't, there are countless reports of people dying and coming back, which is known as Lazarus syndrome. And these people often recall out-of-body experiences and other conscious experiences. These examples support that consciousness may persist during sleep and even after death. So it may not be a stretch to propose that consciousness exists outside of material reality. If this is true, that means that it could be possible for consciousness to exist past a sudden end in the universe. And just as we create entire subconscious worlds in our dreams modeled after our conscious lives, this collective consciousness could have done something similar by creating an alternate reality similar to the one we once lived in. Human beings and life would all still be in this alternate reality, and things would be very, very close to how they were remembered, with some occasional differences that may be responsible for the Mandela effect. As always, I really appreciate each and every single one of you guys for sticking it through to the end of this video. I am very interested to see what you guys have to say about this theory in the comments below. And make sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.